Sparks his beginning play last week. Ohio State hoping he's the final piece that lifts the Buckeyes to the Final Four. Every Big Ten matchup is important. This one will be special. The Buckeyes and Hoosiers next.
Indiana ESPN presents NCAA basketball. A Big Ten battle as the fourth-ranked Buckeyes of Ohio State face the fifth-ranked Hoosiers of Indiana. Hello once again, everyone, and welcome to...
Your snowfall of the season hit early this morning, casting a cold, quiet atmosphere over this Midwestern town. But there's plenty of heat being generated inside with 17,357 at Assembly Hall to see the number 4 and number 5 ranked teams in the country. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Patrick, and it's great to have you with us for two of the hottest teams in the country, the defending co-champions in the Big Ten. Ohio State is 11-1, and the Buckeyes are trying to win back-to-back Big Ten championships for the first time in 28 years.
And cut through the defense. We're going to watch his motion without the basketball. He's perpetual motion, always looking for an advantage. Freeze it right here. Freeze it. Now watch Jackson as he's going to run what we call a circle move and then cut down the defensive lane as he's going to slide right down the lane of the defense and get a little layup. See, constant motion, moving without the basketball. Very difficult to defend a guy that moves without the ball. And there's the great inside cut. Tremendous without the ball. Hey, when you think of Indiana, you think of man-to-man defense. Last year, Steve Smith was a super at Michigan State. Let's see if they play head-to-head man-to-man defense. Here is Smith, and he's being checked by Greg Graham. Now watch as he runs the baseline. Smith trying to direct traffic, and he rotates up on top. Watch right here. Now look at the switch. Now right here, he's being checked by Jamal Meeks. So now we have Graham and
come over.
Tell me some of the things you can buy for under a dollar.
Assembly Hall in Bloomington with a sellout crowd of more than 17,000 to see Ohio State versus Indiana. And now for tonight's McDonald's starting lineups. For Ohio State, a veteran starting five, and for Captain Jamal Brown, pleasant memories of this arena with a career-high 29 points here last year. Randy Ayers in his third season as head coach with a 54-18 record. He was the Big Ten and in many polls the National Coach of the Year last season. For Indiana, a change in the lineup because of the illness of Alan Henderson, flu and a strep throat. Calbert Chaney is the player who can carry this team, but his numbers are off from a great sophomore season. And Bob Knight, the Hall of Fame coach in his 21st year here with 470 wins, 10 Big Ten, and 3 national championships.
They're really going to miss Henderson on the glass, but in a one-game shot, you might be able to make up for his loss. He brought a new dimension, averaging 8 rebounds a game, Mike.
Chris Reynolds starts at the point. He and Meeks have done an outstanding job switching there. Chaney.
Being checked by Jimmy Jackson immediately.
Eric Anderson trying to penetrate, kicks it back outside to Greg Graham, and then they throw it away. A rare turnover for Chris Reynolds, who has 59 assists and only 13 turnovers coming into this game.
He has really provided a spark, especially with his personality defensively. Look at the way he gets down defensively.
He's on Baker, the leading assist man for the Buckeyes. This is Robinson. He's got a big size advantage inside, but he missed, and Anderson has the rebound.
Last year, Indiana wasn't a good rebounding team until they had Henderson this year. There's their passing game. Pass and go away.
Reach-in foul called on Jim Jackson.
Eric Anderson couldn't practice yesterday, Mike. He was under the weather with the flu. They don't know how long he'll be able to go. He's going to try to gut it out. Number 32, the senior.
And really, Dick, you had to figure these teams were so equal coming in, and then with Henderson being hurt, that sort of wipes out the home court advantage.
Also, Lawrence Funderburk will be a big presence in this game, now sitting on a bench.
Damon Bailey gets his own rebound. The follow is good, and he's fouled.
He has really played well in his last two starts, averaging 16 points a game.
Robinson gets the personal, the second against Ohio State.
Bailey's not a big player, but he really knows how to utilize the head fake. Now look how he uses the head fake to free himself, and now he has good instincts, keeps the ball alive. Now there's the pump. He says, come on, Robinson, you're 7 foot, but you can't get a piece of this.
averaging nearly four rebounds a game, and he can leap in that 6'3 body.
Indiana became a really outstanding team when they decided to go to an eight-man rotation. I thought earlier this year, Coach Knight substituting so much, benching guys. Now they got the rotation they want.
The three-point play by Damon Bailey makes it 3-0. Baker with a left hand, won't go. Tipped by Robinson, won't go. And the follow is by Baker, 3-2.
And there's the full-court trap. They'll trap the initial pass and then rotate back into man-to-man defense. They just try to get you out of the rhythm.
Jent at 6'7 ends up on the 6'3 Bailey.
Jamal Brown now playing on Chaney.
Constant cutting and running. Basket will not go, but there's another foul.
The one thing they lose without Henderson here, in addition to his rebounding prowess, is the fact that Graham now has to become a starter. Randy Ayers was really concerned today in the hotel lobby because he felt that Bobby Knight had finally got the rotation he wanted. Graham's been averaging in his last four games off the bench, 16.5 a game.
Last foul was called on Baker, his first, but the third team foul. And Graham, a 77% shooter who had hit 32 of the last 38, misses that one. He's been hot from the floor as well as the free throw line.
I really think they get a greater spark with Graham coming off the bench. They're trying to control Jackson Bailey, playing him right now. He should be a little physically too strong. Should post on Bailey. That's where he's want to go with the ball.
This is Jent. Jackson has not touched the ball very much so far. Brown tries to dump it off and throws it away. Here comes Indiana. Chaney can be so explosive.
Very streaky player. He's been a little bit inconsistent.
A couple games early in the season, he got to sit an awful lot. Another drive by Graham, and another foul. It looked like Robinson will pick up his second.
Chaney's numbers have really dropped this year as we take a look right here. Look at his field goal percentage. 59% last year, 49% this year. Rebounds have dropped as well, and naturally it's reduced his point totals. But they say he's playing a much more complete game in the last six basketball games.
Four team fouls now against Ohio State. Indiana has yet to commit one with 17:49 on the first half clock.
This is an amazing statistic. Indiana has made more free throws than their opponents have attempted. 279 they have made, and their opponents have only attempted 200.
And that's because you've got guys like Graham and Chaney and Bailey who like to slash to the basket.
That's their style of play as well. So they want to get Jackson away from the middle of the floor.
That time he got to the middle and missed, but he'll draw the personal. And it's on Greg Graham, his first.
They want to keep Jackson. Here's Jackson right here offensively. And they want to keep him away from the middle. Freeze it right there. Freeze it. See, Jackson right here becomes dangerous. He can penetrate. He can really operate in here where he can't give help. They want to keep him away from the middle of that floor.
Robinson, who has Bailey on him, about a foot's worth of difference in height, but they can't take advantage of it. Here comes Graham.
Perimeter shooting's really a problem also on a consistent basis for Indiana.
Bailey leans into that one, no whistle, and here come the Buckeyes, down 6-2. Brown stripped from behind by Graham.
Slow it up.
Three on two.
Not a good play right there. Should have slowed it up at the foul line and hit the trailer.
But Chris Reynolds got the follow, and Bill Robinson gets his third foul in 3 minutes.
And here comes Lawrence. I guarantee you, here comes Lawrence. No, he's not going with Lawrence yet.
Brandaway will come in instead. I was thinking the same thing you were, Dick.
See the deflection from the rear. They really do this well, Indiana. The guys who retreat really... Now watch right here. See, he should slow up. He should slow up at the foul line, and he had a trailer. He could have kicked it right back to number 40 for an easy basket.
Reynolds, only a 59% free throw shooter.
Robinson
has to sit down with that third in 3 minutes.
He really has a problem with the pace of the game, Mike. He doesn't have the kind of quickness for a game that features athletic people like this.
7-2 Hoosiers.
Indiana's extending their defense a little bit more this year, trying to push offenses out a little further.
Baker goes cross court, Brown for three. Won't go. Bailey rebound.
Last year, Brown didn't miss that. Had the great start. Nice pass. Great play.
1-2 and Reynolds score.
Good 45-degree angle cut. They're having a tough time getting the ball to Jackson. They're rotating and switching a lot of people on him.
That foul called on Greg Grand, the team's second and his second.
Bobby Knight said, we are playing better, and all you have to do is check the scores. They blow out Minnesota by 46, and 48 hours later, Minnesota beats Michigan.
Well, in that nine-game win streak, they are beating people by 31 points a game. That's incredible.
And that isn't really Cupcake City.
No. 9-2 Indiana, 16:25 to go, first half. Jackson got inside that time and missed again. Anderson with a rebound to Bailey. He wants to go end-to-end. Basket counts, but it's offensive. Let's see if they wave it off. Will be good.
I agree with Damon Bailey. That is an absolute bad call. He never stepped in front. Damon Bailey with us. I tell you, is he playing aggressive offensively? He steps in. Now, here comes the defender. I think the defender's a half step slow establishing position. I think he's a half step slow. I think that's a makeup call.
You can't run under somebody who has already left the ground. You have to be there.
Thank you. Two things Indiana's doing a lot better job of here than he did earlier this season. One, pushing the ball up the floor and extending their defense out a little further.
It is 11-2 Indiana, and Gent throws it through the hands of Jim Jackson. Ohio State is rattled on the road, and they're down 11-2.
What you doing back there, Raphael?
Well, I'm cooking.
Lawrence Funderburk came to Indiana. He did so because he wanted the discipline of Bob Knight. Being introduced and the crowd on its feet, some of them booing his first trip back to the school that he transferred from. And, Dick, you know he'd love to ring up about 30 tonight.
Well, he had a great game against Northwestern. They were down 7 at the half. He came off the bench, scored 16 points, 8 block shots, and had 8 rebounds and 4 block shots. It was incredible.
Field goal percentage so far, Ohio State 14%. That's why they're down 11-2.
He's checking Anderson right now. They've battled in practice on a number of occasions.
Anderson down the lane.
Anderson set him up and ran him right into a screen. Perfect execution and utilizing the interior screen by Anderson. He bumped Funderburk for the layup.
13-2. And Baker throws it away.
Mike, I think two factors have to happen for Ohio State that have not so far for Randy Ayers' team. One, get some transition layups, and two, some offensive rebounds. They won't beat Indiana 5-on-5. Indiana has a better half-court game.
The Buckeyes have turned it over 4 times. In 4.5 minutes, they're down 13-2 and really look rattled here in Bloomington.
This is the best I've seen Indiana play. I've had them several times. Had them in that loss against UCLA and a win against St. John's.
And keep in mind, this is without their outstanding freshman, Alan Henderson, who can't play because of a strep throat.
They seem to have a spark. They're moving well. They're going to the basket strong.
Anderson too strong on that one. Gent with the rebound. Ohio State needs a bucket.
They have to get some easy baskets. They've had a tough time getting the ball to Jackson.
Funderburk fall away, won't go. Bailey with a rebound. And now Funderburk pushes Anderson. Got away with it. The official wasn't watching. Cheney goes down. He's tripped. It's a foul.
Don't believe there wasn't some bitterness in his transfer. We keep hearing all the right words. But Bobby Knight was absolutely just frustrated with the work ethic of Lawrence Funderburk. And Lawrence Funderburk was frustrated that Bobby Knight would not release him so he could go to Louisville or the school of his choice. He came back to Indiana, finished the semester out, so therefore he didn't need the release. He's
quick inbounds to Cheney, and he makes it 15-2.
Good set play. He right now is at Ohio State, where he's playing without a scholarship, because when you transfer in the Big Ten, you can't get financial aid. So he had to apply for all the different Pell Grants, etc.
Keep an eye on Funderburk inside, because he is not averse to throwing an elbow. He is a tough kid. He'll fight you. 15-2 Indiana, streaking on top.
What a defensive performance. They have really contained Jackson.
Gent misses a three. Here comes Graham.
And they're rotating different people on Jimmy Jackson.
Ohio State trying to avoid being knocked out early. Anderson got away with palming the ball and then dribbled it out of bounds.
The one thing that happened last year in this arena, Ohio State had the big lead, 48-29, and they took the crowd right out of the game. Indiana came back in the second half, narrowed it to about three with a minute and 20, but didn't have enough and lost 93-85.
13:40 to go in the half. This is a team that averages 85 points a game. They have two.
See, Bailey's now playing Jackson on a box.
The three-pointer by Jamal Brown breaks the string, and it's 15-5.
Brown's had a good year shooting the basketball, better than 50% from three-point range.
Reynolds breaks the press easily. That's the other point, Dick. If you don't score, you can't set up your press. Bailey got by Gent. Double-team, had it blocked. Gent with the ball, and he's fouled by Bailey. That's two on Damon Bailey.
Damon Bailey's really driving to the basket. He's doing a lot of things what Duke does with their program down at Blue Devil Land. They like to drive with the basketball. Now take a look right here. There's Bailey in a one-on-one. He's in a one-on-one maneuver, drives to the goal. There's Jet. There's the help defensively by Jackson. And they get the foul. Tim Higgins gets the foul on Bailey.
Alex Davis, number 20, has checked into Ohio State's lineup for Jamal Brown.
He's a good open court player, but he hasn't been able to get in the open court, Baker.
Baker with a runner, won't go. Tip, Jackson gets the bucket.
Jackson from the weak side. There's the trap. There's the diagonal pass, the simplest way to break it.
And they have a three-on-two blocking foul. Boy, Funderburk upset about that one. He thought he had drawn a charge.
Funderburk was part of the great class of 1989. Some said at that time that it was the best class. Calvert Cheney and Funderburk were partners. There he is now. Look at him rotate over. No, he doesn't beat him to the spot. You have to establish position and then beat the offensive player to the spot.
And that is the seventh team foul, Dick, against Ohio State. So already Indiana will be in the bonus. They've hit five out of seven from the line. Now make it six out of eight.
Mike, I've been very critical about the fact that Indiana doesn't utilize the three-point shot sufficiently. Talking to Bobby Knight today in the locker room, I said, Bobby, you guys don't go to the three-point shot. And then we talked about the free throw line. They make up the difference on the free throw line. 279 made. Their opponents have only attempted 200.
And they always have good free throw shooters to take advantage of those opportunities. Here's Gent with a runner. And Ohio State now finding its rhythm, 17-9.
Gent's one of those aggressive, emotional players. He scraps, has a good touch. Indiana really drilled to handle that pressure.
Bailey for two.
What a great tip.
Cheney, it's good, but it's overruled. And Cheney called for the foul. That got the crowd on its feet.
He climbs back. Calvert Cheney, number 40, watch him now. Tries to get a lane to the basket. On his little push, they missed two pushes. And there's the tip.
Tough to see what Cheney did to be called for a foul on that play. That's Jamal Meeks, who is in at the point guard. He does a great job, as well as Reynolds, at protecting the ball.
And he also puts a lot of pressure on the basketball defensively. Really harasses people.
Jackson for three.
Jackson has really improved his range, shooting 51% from three-point land.
Ohio State had hit its last three field goal attempts.
Trying to swing the ball, so you get the good angle, bring it to this. So you can bring the ball to that wing, you'll get a good angle on a box.
There's a pass saved by Meeks, who is not much of a danger to shoot. That's a good pass to get it to Cheney. Smart play.
Indiana likes to break the defenses down, swinging the ball to the side.
Offensive foul, Calvert Cheney. That's two on him.
Indiana really attacking the basket with dribble penetration.
No basket, so we have a timeout with 11:33 to go in the half. It's an eight-point lead.
There's no distinction between...
Indiana's 13-point lead has been cut, but the Hoosiers are still up by eight. And during this nine-game winning streak, they have played brilliant basketball. Your eyes immediately go to the points, but look at the field goal percentage. They've held their opponents to 36% shooting. Seven of the nine teams, I mean, just have been throwing up bricks, and that's because of that man's defense.
Yeah, they really play solid man-to-man defense, and they've beaten on some good basketball teams. That blowout over Minnesota, they say the first half was just sensational.
Matenover, number 24, is in for the first time for Indiana. Good inside player, especially on defense.
And an experienced player. Good legs, good jumper, physical.
He's got Funderburk, who works for that one-hand jumper. Won't go. Boy, no second chances except for the Jackson tip-in for Ohio State.
No easy baskets. No easy what we call offensive rebounds or transition layups.
Cheney against Brandewey, one-on-one.
Indiana's doing a much more better job of driving to the basket, getting into isolations one-on-one. And that creates fouling situations.
Nice pass to Jackson, who's sealed off inside.
That's what makes him so special, his strength and his ability to post as well as play on the perimeter.
He has four. Damon Bailey got away with maybe a double dribble, and Indiana still saves it. Runner by Graham. Big rebound to Funderburk.
Funderburk gives them a presence that they don't have when he's not on the floor.
Jamal Brown for three, and then all at once, it is a three-point game. Brown. Indiana had gone up 15-2, but now with 10 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the half, Ohio State has closed to within three.
Brown had the big game last year, 29 points, his career high. One of those underrated players, a super defender as well.
Meeks, great pass to Cheney.
Cheney right down the gut of the defense. They really utilize that inside cut, that slashing cut to the basket.
Dick, they own the lane, don't they?
They really do a great job in driving down the lane without the basketball. Now look at Jackson playing up on a point. Now a slide inside, trying to post on Bailey.
Jackson free at the baseline, but the miss.
Simple little maneuver to get him free. Pass the ball, cut through the defense.
Meeks has the Dick Vitale haircut working for him. And
Jamal Meeks really going to spark coming off the bench. Hasn't pouted about the fact that he's not starting.
Only averages 3 points a game, but he has two in this one. Funderburk kicks it back outside. Brown for three again.
Ohio State's got to make the extra pass. They're making one pass looking at the basket.
Bailey walked.
See how Indiana's trying to attack the basket with dribble penetration. That's what Duke does such a great job with.
Fourth turnover against the Hoosiers. Anderson comes back in for Bob Knight. Cheney will go out along with Meeks and Bailey. Skelton is in for the first time for Ohio State.
Hit a big three in that game against Northwestern. They were really on the ropes. He tied the game up, Skelton. They also have a good, solid player in Alex Davis. They got a tremendous backcourt when you count Jackson as a backcourt performer.
Jackson looks inside.
Excellent ball handler. Doesn't have an ego. Very unselfish. Maybe to a fault.
Funderburk with a runner, and he has been ice cold since coming into the game, much to the delight of the Indiana fans.
Not a good shot. Not within the rhythm of their offense.
Well, you know how badly he wants to do well here. Anderson. Nice cut. And he'll draw the foul.
They want the basket. They want the basket.
Jamal Brown commits the personal.
0-0-7. Anderson, a little one-on-one maneuver. Indiana doing a lot of this tonight. Taking the ball in one-on-one situations and driving right at the defense to create foul opportunities. Look at the free throw line. 7 out of 9 already tonight.
And it's a 7-point lead. That's the difference in the ballgame.
Like, I can't emphasize enough. When you think about that statistic, making 279 free throws in 13 games, and the opposition's made only 200. To put it in perspective, look at the difference Indiana and Ohio State. Indiana's 279 to 378 coming into the game. Ohio State, who does go to the line also, is only 175 out of 249.
That's a huge difference. And you're right, Ohio State, not a bunch of perimeter shooters.
That's a 124-point differential. That's a lot of points.
Jackson has range and hits. That's a two.
Bobby Knight.
6 points for Jackson.
He had all the adjectives describing Jackson. Loves him as a player.
Here's a foul before the shot. And Ohio State really digging itself a big hole in the foul category.
Bobby Knight said that Jimmy Jackson, what he likes about him, he's under control on the floor at all times. He said, I also like the fact that he doesn't force shots, because the Knight system has always been built upon shot selection,
sure,
and discipline. He would love, his eyes just lit up in the locker room when I was talking about Jimmy.
Greg Graham at the line, misses the first, he'll get another.
Graham came out of Indianapolis when he came out of high school, was part of that class of 1989, Funderburg, Cheney, Chris Lawson, who transferred to Vanderbilt.
Uh-huh. Funderburg booed as he leaves. Steve Hall comes in.
Look at this here. Now it's up to 288. Made. That's made. The opponents have not attempted 200.
Graham has now hit 4 out of 6 himself. He has the only 2 misses.
Good decision by Randy Ayers to take Funderburg out for a moment or two.
Yes.
You said it so accurately, Mike. He's pressing. He's trying to make things happen so quickly on the floor. Really
Jackson
denied.
Being shadowed by Chris Reynolds. He can't get the ball. Brown doesn't get the roll.
That was a great defensive play by Reynolds, denying the ball up on top to Jackson so that they can't get Jackson in the middle, number one. And number two, don't allow Ohio State to reverse the ball.
Anderson, nice pump fake. Gets it low to Nova. Maybe one pass too many, and they lose it out of bounds. But last touch by Ohio State.
Didn't have good spacing right there. Normally in their offense, they have excellent spacing. As he goes down to the lane and lays a screen, and then Cheney is going to come right in this area here, catch the ball, and get a layup. Now watch Bailey, 22, right here. Freeze it. See how he sets the screen? Now here comes Mr. Cheney, right down the lane for a layup. Thank you, Mr. Bailey. Take me home, Mr. Bailey.
Kind of things that never show up in the statistics. Kind of things that coaches and other players appreciate.
And the kind of things that puts Bobby Knight in the Hall of Fame.
That's right.
Oh, look at his zone. Look at his zone now. 1-2-2 zone. Makes the adjustment in a timeout. Watch Jen up on top, and then he'll slide inside and make it a 2-3. See how Jen drops down to the top of the circle. Is wide open.
Meek's not known for his outside shooting, but he buries that one. It was a 2. He had a toe on the line. The lead is back to 10.
Mike, I could have made that shot wide open.
Dick, I've seen you miss that shot. Uh-oh. Air ball fired up by Skelton.
Skelton from out of Dayton, Ohio.
Jackson fouled by Reynolds, who was hand-checking him, and Bob Knight is up really complaining about the call.
Reynolds really loves defense. Bobby Knight talked about Chris Reynolds in the same mode as Quinn Buckner, who back in 1976 was a brilliant player here. Look at wide open at the top of the circle, ball reversal, attack the zone, step in a gap up on top. See, a lot of teams like to go odd-even. I talked about that last night against the zone defense. If they have a one-man front, you want 2 men up on top. If they have a 2-man front, you want 1 guy in the middle to force 2 to play them.
Jackson, no weaknesses in his game, an 80% free throw shooter, 7 points tonight.
That's the greatest compliment Chris Reynolds could receive when Bobby Knight speaks about him in the same mode as Mr. Quinn Buckner.
You bet. 26-18, 6:50 to go first half. Meeks and Reynolds together right now in the backcourt, essentially 2-point guard.
Half-court trap. He's wearing the same number as Buckner, number 21. See, Indiana's going to try to get right in the gap. See how he tried to force 2 people to play up? See how he drives right at 2?
Dick, not much firepower out there right now. Graham and Anderson, the only people you'd look to score.
The reason they're in this defense now is to force Indiana to shoot the perimeter shot, and they're answering the call. But the defense is there to make them shoot the perimeter shot. If they knock it down, you're in trouble.
Anderson has hit 9 of his last 13 three-pointers. There's Gent from the outside.
He gets the deuce, but it's a forced shot. Like, not really getting any kind of fluidity to their offense. Three-quarter, 1-2-2, trap. See, Gent's going to try to force him into a trapping area. He's fanning them to the sideline.
Oh, is that a great job by Meeks? Couldn't get rid of the ball, so he points where he wants his teammate to go so he can get him the ball and beat the press.
And notice how Indiana flashed somebody right to the open area in the middle of the floor.
Anderson fakes the three-pointer this time.
See, the zone defense is forcing him now to play on a perimeter. Oh, what a great head fake. What a great head fake.
Greg Graham with a baseline drive, 31-20. Graham has 8.
I would get out of that zone. They are not really operating the zone effectively. One reason, they don't play it a great deal. They're not sliding as a unit.
Bad pass and the steal by Reynolds.
Nothing fancy by Chris Reynolds. Just anticipate, catch the basketball, and lay it down.
Steve Hall really telegraphed that last pass.
He's a perfect Bobby Knight kind of player, number 21. He loves the challenge right now of playing Jackson. Look at him. He's fighting to get over the top. He says, come on, Jimmy, shoot it over me. And Jimmy says, I will.
Jackson took that one all on his own after getting the ball out of bounds. He has 10 of Ohio State's 22.
That was a great move by Meeks right there to stop before he crossed half court so he could reverse the ball to a teammate and not have a backcourt violation. Just little things like that.
Meeks tossed that one away. Gent for three.
Shooting too quickly, Mike. Shooting too quickly.
This foul will be on Hall trying to get the follow. There seems to be a sense of desperation in the way Ohio State is running its offense. Coming up later tonight on
perimeter game. They don't have a perimeter game. They got some good athletes. Jamie Brandon and company now playing on a perimeter, but they don't have the perimeter shot, and they don't have the good shot selection, and that's really created a dilemma for them. Alabama, Whip Sanderson just continues to win, and everybody talks about Kentucky's and LSU's and Arkansas's, and all Alabama does is get W after W. Robert Horry and Shaquille O'Neal.
Anderson with 7 points.
He's playing really under the weather. Could not practice the last 2 days. And remember, Allen Henderson is not in uniform. He's home in bed. Allen, we wish you a speedy recovery, big fella. He's a perfect example of being a student athlete. Henderson had over 1,200 on his SATs.
I did too, but I took it twice. It's combined total. 4:30 to go in the half. 35-22 Indiana. It's been the Hoosiers all the way.
They start out in a 1-2-2 set and then slide to the boxes inside.
This is Baker. See, Funderburk back in there.
Indiana really trying to force him to play on one side of the floor and not allow him to bring the ball back.
Funderburk finally gets a roll on a shot. He has his first two.
Coming out of high school, he was one of the top five players with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny Anderson, Allen Houston, Jimmy Jackson.
Ohio State stays in the zone. Good pass inside. Novert tried to cut before he had his hands on it and turned it over. Jackson leans into one, keeps it alive, and here comes Meeks.
Good decision.
4-on-3.
Good decision. Backed it out. Go to the high percentage offense. Break down the defense. They're staying with the zone.
Even though he had the numbers, he didn't have a very good angle to attack from.
See, one of the reasons they're staying in the zone because Reynolds and Meeks are not supposed to be shooters.
Here's Meeks. Buries it.
What happens to scouting reports? You scout, you evaluate, you say he can't shoot, you say Reynolds can't shoot, you zone. Randy Ayers does everything right, and they bury the jumper.
The tip-in looked like Jackson got it. Back to your point about the scouting reports, you look at Meeks. He's hit 3 out of 11 three-pointers. You let him take them all night.
Unbelievable. See how they slide right behind the trapping area.
38-26, foul on that play. Jackson picks up the personal, his second.
Freeze it. Right here. Now watch right here how he's going to curl into the middle of the floor. And that's where you want to attack this gap area here to give you numbers. You want to get right into the middle area. It's going to curl right in the middle. And they're going to enter. Thank you. That's how you beat pressure. And then notice the boxes here. How they have a guy in great offensive rebound position.
Graham has hit 5 out of 7 free throws. They get 6 out of 8, and Indiana extends its lead to 14 at 40-26 with 2:56 to go in the half.
Anderson is going to reverse the basketball against the zone. Now watch how slow the zone slides back, and then watch the penetration here and then a kick out here. Now watch right here. They're going to reverse the ball. Freeze it. Right here is where he attacks the gap. He forces him to give help, and there's a wide-open shot here. Now there it goes. Boom. Thank you. Meeks gets the wide-open shot because of the dribble penetration by Reynolds.
Ohio State shooting under 37% in the last 3 games in the first half. Funderburk back to Gent. Tipped in. Nice job by Tom Brandoy.
Brandoy is one of those kids that hangs around the basket. He gives you everything he has. They're trying to keep when Funderburk so offensively in the box down inside, not allowing him to spin to the middle of the court.
Indiana has hit its last seven field goals, and now Ohio State back to a man-to-man.
These 2 minutes are big psychologically for Ohio State to try and get it to single digits. Good spacing, typical of Indiana, 15 to 17 feet apart. Laid a back screen. Remember, the screener's the most dangerous guy. He lays the screen, and then he steps back from the screen like Anderson did right there.
Shot clock at 9, and Anderson for 3, but he missed.
He laid the screen and then popped back out.
Baker ahead to Brown. Brown collides with Jamal Meeks, and Randy Ayers wanted the foul. He won't get it.
Mike, I cannot remember a transition 3-on-1, 2-on-1 layup by Ohio State.
That was the closest thing they've had to a breakaway.
Exactly, the closest look to what we call an up-tempo layup in transition.
Hoosiers by 12, a minute 40 to go, first half from Bloomington.
Nova lays some big screens. Oh, look at Nova trying to go lay a screen, like Sloan screened 45 several years ago.
Bob Knight always had some guys who would go out there and lay it on the line. Anderson,
nope.
Nice save there.
Watch number 24. He's going out.
And then a bad pass.
Yeah, sloppy performance in that possession.
Seventh turnover, Indiana. There's the layup.
That's the first one all night, as far as I'm concerned, what I call a real fast break opportunity.
And they get it with 1:16 to go in the first half to cut the lead to 10.
You better believe psychologically that's a big difference if you can go in under 10.
And Reynolds walks. Join us tomorrow. Big East FYU against Stanford at 12.
Cameron Crazy's going to go wild. I saw a great arena last night. The Hearn Center, Missouri, the Antlers. Great environment.
Funderburk. He walked.
Funderburk said, I've been dreaming of this situation, and the dream usually has come out my way. I read an article today in the Indianapolis paper. I'll tell you the one thing, though, that has impressed me about Funderburk. Had the big game against Northwestern, made his presence known against Michigan State. He has not tried to make up 2 years in two games. He's playing with some poise and an understanding that he's got himself this year plus two more years in an Ohio State uniform.
Randy Ayers gets Jim Jackson out of the game. Even though there's 51 seconds to go in the half, he doesn't want him to pick up a third foul. Here's what Indiana has done in the field goal department as we break down the first half for you. There is a 5-second difference between the game clock and the shot clock, so they can't hold for the last attempt of the half.
There isn't another team in America that utilizes the screen on the inside as well as Indiana. They're always looking to make that back cut.
They can really wear out.